Hi, beauty finders. This is Mathias Ellen again, and today I'm going to take you behind the scenes on exactly what I used for the 2014 Emmy Awards with actress SELENIS LEYVA from Orange is the New Black. I promised you a complete makeup breakdown, and today we're going to get right into the nitty-gritty. So, if you've watched my makeup tutorial / behind the scenes over the weekend with me and SELENIS, you know that I showed you a lot of great looks. I created 4 amazing looks on her. Let's see, Saturday morning, Saturday night, Sunday morning, Sunday night. Five looks, because the Emmy Awards on Monday was the 5th look. And I wanted to take you behind the scenes and tell you a little bit about what I used. Actually, a lot about what I used, because I have some of my favorite products right here that I used on her, and I want to share them with you for the actual Emmy Awards red carpet. So what I want to tell you first is that I started with a new primer that I just got, and this is from Tarte Cosmetics, and it's called the Clean Slate Timeless Smoothing Primer. It's not liquidy, but it's not creamy because it's not wet. So it's, I want to say that it's very dense. It's great for oily skin, and it's great for skin that has large pores. I have large pores, and SELENIS LEYVA also, I think, really, really, really benefited from this product. So this is something that is a little bit similar to the Smashbox Photo Finish, in that it has like a silicone-y feel. But it's much denser and it's much richer, so it goes on the skin more like a moisturizer, but it doesn't moisturize the skin. It just kind of like fills in all the imperfections and flaws that we have from crow's feet or large pores or, you know, just uneven texture, and it puts like a base, a really good strong base. And I'm really totally loving how this went on her skin for the day. And it keeps your makeup on like forever. And it is great from Tarte, because Tarte is one of my favorite products. So I started with this. So after the Clean Slate Smoothing Primer, I wanted to really make sure that SELENIS' skin stayed nice and matte, because she does, as she told me, tend to shine. She does have a lot of oil production in her skin. So, and I was looking through like pictures of her red carpet stuff and appearances that she had done in New York with other makeup artists, and she does have a lot of shine. So I really wanted to like pow pow get that shine down. So not only did I use this Clean Slate Primer from Tarte, which is great for large pores, but I went in with the fantastic product from Smashbox. This is PHOTOMATTE Anti-Shine. This PHOTOMATTE Anti-Shine is phenomenal. This will stop all of your pores from producing oil. Well, it's not like gonna like kill your skin, but it's definitely gonna keep your shine at bay for hours and hours and hours, and I love this stuff. This is even great, like I'm shooting a lot of videos today, and I'm gonna probably even be putting this on like between takes, because you can actually put it on top of foundation and powder, and it just like that, like sucks it all in. So I'm gonna tell you about her complexion. So I used one of my fantastic foundations that I love from Urban Decay. This is the Naked Skin Foundation. Now, they say that this is weightless, ultra definition liquid makeup. I love that they call this ultra definition, not HD, because everyone's doing HD. I mean, come on, it's so passe. So this is the ultra definition weightless liquid makeup. Now, I've been using this for a couple years in my kit, or maybe it's been about a year and a half. It hasn't really been around that long. Anyway, I jumped on this as soon as I found it. This is a fantastic foundation. I love the packaging. I love the long, slender bottle, and I love the silver top. But what I love about this product is that it also has a silicone base, I believe. It's oil-free, and it just glides on the skin really beautifully, effortlessly. It matches anybody's complexion, whether it is dry or oily or in between. It goes on anyone. Now, the only thing that I want to tell you, a quick makeup artist secret, is that you can get your shade to be in the same color family as your skin or your client's skin, But a lot of times you'll be working with a client that's maybe a little bit more Latino or Asian. And both of those skin tones tend to be a lot more yellow, a lot more olive. So I always come with my little angel in disguise in my kit from Makeup Forever Professional, Chromatic Mix. Now, this is, I believe, also a silicone-based foundation mixer. This comes in a few different shades, and this is the yellow olive. It's very, very, very olive, more so than yellow. It's not a canary yellow, it's almost a yellow green. And this little angel saves my butt. And I bring this with me everywhere I go. Because what happens is, I'll pull out my fantastic Urban Decay foundation and I'll match her skin tone, meaning like the tone of it. You know, this is actually 6.5. So I used 6.5 on her. 6 was too light, 7 was too deep. But the problem with 6.5 is that it has a peachy caramel underglow. So I take my little yellow olive Makeup Forever Chromatic Mix, which comes out completely yellow green, and it is fantastic to mix with the foundation. Now, can you see that? I don't want to put much more than that because when I mix them together, I don't want it to become like really ugly mustard foundation, which you're all like, Mathias, what the hell are you trying to do to that woman's face? No, you just put a drop or two and you mix the two together. Here, let me just blend it out a little bit in a circle. Do you kind of see that color right there? See how it's like a yellow green? Yeah, it's very mustard. It's totally mustard. Anyway, you mix these two together. And I mix those on my Pro palette. And then when you apply to the skin of someone who is more olive undertoned, depending on what part of the world or country or heritage they are, this completely will transform the foundation. It will cancel out any of the peachy, kind of too orangey undertones, and it'll totally make the foundation match. So you've definitely got to try this Makeup Forever Chromatic Mix. This also comes in white, and I have this in white too. Two little angels on both sides always fly with me, the white and this olive green. Love this. Next, once your foundation's on, which is on top of the primer, next thing I want to do is conceal under the eyes. And concealing under the eyes is, you know, there's lots of different ways you can conceal under the eyes. I have just fallen in love with a new product from a line that I am obsessed with called It Cosmetics. If you guys don't know what It Cosmetics is yet, you need to check it out. I'm going to put a link down in my bio for It Cosmetics. So It Cosmetics has made something they call Bye Bye Under Eye. I love that name, Bye Bye Under Eye. The names are great. The packaging looks very medicinal, very professional in that way. It's not cutesy and kitschy like some lines like, what's that line that's really, oh, Benefit Cosmetics or what's that other one? Too Faced? Yeah, no, it's not kitschy like that. But the names are cute. Bye Bye Under Eye. But this is the light Bye Bye Under Eye Corrector. Comes a little top. And it's also dense, and there's a lot of color, and it has like anti-inflammatory ingredients, I believe. And this worked great under her eye. Use this under the eye to cancel out any discoloration. I also, another makeup artist trick is that I almost always, do foundation first, and I put that everywhere, even under the eyes, because I feel that foundation really does half the battle. You know, it's kind of like sending in your troops before you actually send in the king. And so foundation is like the troops. It's like they're out there to do half the battle first, so that the king comes in on his trolley train throne on wheels, and he doesn't really need to fight off too much of the battle, right? Because the soldiers have already come in. So your foundation is gonna do half the battle. So foundation goes under the eye. and then concealer then goes on top. Also, by adding a couple of layers, I feel that your foundation and concealer are gonna last longer because there's more product on the skin for the skin to like actually sit and sink in through. So that's what I do for skin. And then I set it with the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. This is a fantastic powder. I use this on a lot of people. It really truly does match like 9 out of 10 women. I mean, I'm not talking about the dark African-American women. I would not probably use this on them. This will probably get too white. But 9 out of 10 of my clients will work with this Laura Mercier Translucent. And it's not too dry, and it's not too wet. Not that powders are wet, that doesn't make sense. But some powders are like hydrating, there's new hydrating powders. I mean, powder is supposed to flatten out your skin, okay? It's not supposed to be hydrating, just my opinion. So, Laura Mercier Translucent Powder, put that basically under the eye, around the T-zone, down on the chin, and then around on the cheek area and on the forehead. Now at the very end, I like to add a little bit of bronzer, but I don't like to add frosty bronzer. I'm just not, especially not for like a red carpet. If I wanna have a little bit of shine or shimmer, I can add that up high on the temple or the cheek, but I don't like a frosty forehead, okay? So, I'm using Urban Decay. Let's see, what's this called? Naked Skin. This is also part of the Naked collection. So the Urban Decay Naked Skin Loose Powder is beautiful. This is Naked Dark. So the Naked Dark is, I believe, the darkest of their shades. And this has like a really soft, kind of floating, air, cloudy, powdery feeling about it. It's different than the Laura Mercier, which is more of a classic, powder to set makeup feeling. This is fantastic for just kind of like, I use it on the temples, I use it along the perimeter of the face. It creates like a definition around the outside of the face. And so I use this on Selenis at the very, very, very end. So those are my complexion tips for how to do the Emmy red carpet look that I did on Selenis. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. Let me see, did I forget anything? I don't think so. Brushes, I can't go into brushes because I don't want you guys sitting here for an hour. I do tons of brush videos about what products and brushes I like to use. So subscribe here for upcoming tips, tricks, and tutorials with me, Mathias Allen, because there's lots of makeup hauls coming up. Also, please follow me on Instagram and Twitter, at mathias4makeup. Because I'm always posting behind the scenes pictures of my adventures and my clients and my jobs and my TV shows and all these really fun things. And I want you guys to follow me. So, and always comment, leave any of your comments below because I really wanna meet you. I wanna like get in there and like talk to you. And the way that I can do that is by commenting back or talking to you through my YouTube page or through my Instagram account or even on my Facebook page. Here's my link to my Facebook page right here. Please like my Facebook page because sometimes I post contests and giveaways on my Facebook page that only you, if you like my Facebook page, can get your little hands on, like a monster, like Lady Gaga. So please follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook and stay tuned for much more. I hope you guys enjoyed this beauty makeup breakdown for the 2014 Emmy Awards with SELENIS LEYVA from Orange Is the New Black. And if you're not watching Orange Is the New Black, you need to get on it. My obsessive compulsive cosmetics color pencil in Hoochie, okay? And I went around the edge and gave it a little bit more definition, like that, around the edge. So I wanted to do something a little bit more fuchsia on the outside and a little bit more bright pink in the center. So the combination of those two pencils was perfect. Then,